Whenever you Google for supplements, you will find creatine everywhere. Since its discovery in 1832, multiple studies have shown its benefits in gaining muscle mass and strength. But how does it actually work, and what are the effects and possible side effects? Let's find it out after the intro.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, this you crazy mother!
First of all, what is creatine? This is the chemical structure, and the UPAC name for it would be 2-carbamimidoylmethylaminoacetic acid. Jesus Christ. This organic compound is a derivative of the basic amino acids glycine, L-arginine, and indirectly methionine. And they are all found naturally in sources of protein. And creatine is synthesized in the liver and the kidneys. From there, it is transported through the blood to places of high energy demand, which would be primarily skeletal muscles. Around 95% of the body's total creatine amount is stored there. With that being said, we come to the main function and metabolic role of creatine, or to be more specific, phosphocreatine, but more to that in a second. When we use our muscles, we obviously spend energy. And in our body, this form of energy is called ATP, standing for adenosine triphosphate. When our muscles contract, they of course need to relax again. And here we need the ATP, which brings our muscles back into their normal state. And that's why when people die, the muscles contract but can't relax anymore, what we know as rigor mortis. So we need ATP, but what is the connection to this one here? Creatine is not producing any ATP.
But if ATP levels are high, or if you're resting, creatine accepts the phosphate of ATP and becomes phosphocreatine, while ATP becomes ADP. Now, if you run out of energy during your workout and your ATP levels are low, the phosphate of phosphocreatine gets transferred back, so ATP is generated, and therefore you will have more energy.
Furthermore, creatine plays a role in the protection of our nerve cells and the modulation of the immune response. By the way, it is not a steroid like testosterone, for example, like many people think. At this point, I quickly want to remind you, don't forget to subscribe for more scientific videos and useful tips and information. And every single like and comment is highly appreciated. Next question, how do I use creatine? The most reliable form of creatine supplements is creatine monohydrate, which is also the most common one and the standard, so to say. It has usually also a very high bioavailability, which means you basically get what you consume. First of all, there is a so-called loading phase, which is still under discussion, in the first week, where you basically fill up the creatine storages in your body. It is recommended that you consume between 15 and 20 grams distributed in 4 equal dosages per day for 1 week straight. But many people said that with this loading phase, you will feel the benefits of creatine faster, but it is not a necessary thing. After that, you just maintain the creatine level with consuming 3 to 5 grams a day. This is just the general recommendation, but everything of course depends on you and your body. What else is there to keep in mind? Studies have shown that if you consume creatine with a sufficient amount of carbs and proteins, it is stored better in your muscles. And if you can, consume it with a sugary drink, as insulin helps the creatine enter the cells. Coming to the effects and side effects, with consuming creatine, you will have therefore more energy, as already explained. Sounds great, right? But what is the catch? Well, first of all, creatine boosts only your energy level. So during your workout, you and your muscles will have a greater amount of energy. Through that, you can push or pull more or longer, which in turn builds muscle mass. But creatine itself, not. It builds up indirectly. So if you consume it and you do not train on a regular basis, it will give you absolutely nothing. Furthermore, creatine leads to water retention in the muscles because of its osmotic effect. So at the end of the day, it might be that you slightly gain weight, but it's not that this has such a big impact on you. And this can actually be even a pretty good thing. So don't worry, you will not look like a balloon. The side effects are not that scary. Connected to that, dehydration might occur, so don't forget to drink enough water at all times. And if you want to learn about the effects of dehydration, I made another video about that, so definitely make sure to check that out as well. Lastly, kidney damage was associated with creatine consumption at one point, but there is no scientific evidence that too much creatine harms our kidneys in any way. I mean, if I would have a renal disease, I wouldn't risk it, I just would not take it, but I think when you are healthy, nothing will happen. I mean, high creatine levels are associated with kidney dysfunctions, but they are not causing them. Generally, the International Society for Sports Nutrition classifies creatine as extremely safe. If you don't exaggerate, that means if you do not consume more than 3 grams a day, it will be definitely harmless. Quickly to myself, I'm not a big fan of supplements at all. I am old school, I prefer it the natural way, so this video is not based on my experience, but on scientific papers and the experiences of other people. If you ever took creatine, comment and share your experience with it, I'm sure it will help the whole community. I hope it was helpful and informative. Thanks a lot for watching, stay healthy, and see you next time.